Hello students, so today we will study that how a magnet helps us in finding the directions. And we are going to begin this module by carrying out a simple activity. For this, we take a bar magnet and suspend it from the middle from a wooden stand by using an unspun thread. Make sure that you use an unspun thread only. And you also need to make sure that this magnet, it can rotate freely and then wait for it to come to rest. Now, it's in rest position. So immediately mark two points on the table using the pen. So you can use a sheet of paper to mark those two points. Now these points, they show the ends of the magnet in the rest position. Now join these two points by using a line. So what does this line represent? Yes, it represents the direction of the direction which is given by the magnet when it is at rest. Now just gently rotate this magnet by gently pushing its one end in any direction using another small weak magnet and let it come to rest. Now observe carefully. Do you find any change in the direction of the magnet? No, right? Now the question is, what does this line represent? Well, this line represents the north-south direction. So what have you observed from this experiment, or what is your inference from this experiment? That a freely suspended bar magnet always points in a particular direction, and that is the north-south direction when it comes to rest. And based on this property of magnets, an instrument named as magnetic compass was also developed. So here is a magnetic compass, and you can see that this instrument is nothing but a small-sized magnetic needle which is pivoted on a low friction point inside a small box with a glass cover on it. And this needle, it is free to rotate in the horizontal plane. Now it has a dial with the directions marked on it, and its magnetic needle always indicates the north-south direction whenever it comes to rest. Now to identify the north pole of this needle, it is painted in a different color, and here it is in red color. You see the red color here? Yes, so that points in the north direction. Now we know that a freely suspended magnet, it always points in the north-south direction when it is at rest. But then some of you may even ask me, why does it depict only north and south direction? Why not any other direction? Well, to solve this problem, a very famous scientist named William Gilbert, he suggested some experimental observations to help us. Well, he conducted various experiments, and through his experiments, he found that the Earth itself behaves like a huge magnet. Or in other words, it behaves as if there's a huge magnet which is buried inside the Earth. So now if we want to visualize this image, we will get some kind of picture like this, where a magnet has been placed inside the Earth, and due to which the Earth, it behaves as a huge magnet. But have you noticed any peculiar thing regarding the alignment of this magnet? So as you can see, that the north pole of this magnet, it is near the geographical south pole of the Earth, while the south pole of the magnet, it is near the geographical north pole of the Earth. So what do you think? What's going to happen when a magnetic compass is placed somewhere on the surface of the Earth? So let us do the same by placing this magnetic compass here. And now, before we proceed, let us just recall the parts of a magnetic compass. So what did we study about the magnetic compass? Yes, so we've studied that the magnetic compass, it contains a small sized magnetic needle which is free to rotate in the horizontal plane. Now, this north pole of the magnetic compass, it always gets attracted by the Earth's magnetic south pole. And the north pole of this magnetic compass needle, it always points towards the geographical north pole or the Earth's magnetic south pole. Similarly, the other end of the compass, that is not marked in red, it always points towards the geographical south pole or the Earth's magnetic north pole. Thus, the Earth's magnetic north and south pole are not the same as geographic north and the south pole. Understood? Okay, students, so what I want you to infer from this experiment is that magnetic compass always points towards the geographical north-south direction. And that's because our Earth behaves as a huge magnet, and as unlike poles, they attract each other, thus the attraction occurs between the north pole of the magnetic compass and the south pole of the Earth's magnet. Thus, the north pole of the magnetic compass, it always corresponds to the geographic north pole or the Earth's magnetic south pole. And the south pole of the magnetic compass, it always corresponds to the geographic south pole or the Earth's magnetic north pole. So just keep this image in mind, and this will make all things clear regarding the poles and, you know, geographical pole and the magnetic poles. Now, what I want you to remember is that the geographical north pole and the magnetic south pole, they're not exactly at the same position. Rather, the magnetic poles of the Earth, they keep on changing. And that's because of some of the changes that take place in the Earth's core. And what are these changes? That you will be studying in your higher classes. So students, I think that by now you're pretty much clear about this concept that the Earth being a huge magnet, it forces the magnetic compass or the suspended magnet to align in the north-south direction. So now before we close on this module, let me give you an application of the magnetic compass. So magnetic compass is usually used by the sailors, and that's because they need to find out the directions and navigate to their desired locations. So that's all for this module, and soon we'll be coming up with more modules on magnetism.